Hello, everyone, and welcome to RTC TV. Tonight, your commentators are myself, Dakota Hayden, and new to the commentary game, I have Maddox Zider with me.
Thanks.
Tonight's matchup is going to be the Casting Comets versus Knox's Redskins, which should be an interesting matchup tonight. I have no idea how good the Redskins
are. That
was
a really
nice
Comets. Really nice kick.
They so far showed it with a nice kick starting off.
Blake Albright is going to be returning it for the Casting Comets. He's down near the 20. I'm going to say the 19. Or the 30. Wow. I'm going to say the 29.
Numbers, Maddox.
I'm not good at them. Never been good at them. Never will be good at them.
That's fine.
It's going to be first and 10. See if they can, you know, the offensive casting can do anything. They really have not been doing very well the past month.
Nah, recently it's been terrible. It's been a real struggle to score any points at all, actually.
I've heard you a few times. I heard you talk about you get really into the games. I'll give you that one.
I know. I'm hoping to not, you know, completely freak out tonight, but that's yet to be figured out or decided. Depends on what happens.
The handoff to 21, Ephraim Amasquita, brought down in the backfield for a loss of one. Actually, no, they're gonna. It's basically a gain of nothing, but also a loss of nothing. It's going to be second and 10 or second 10 and a half, depending on what you want to look at it.
Well, a gain is good, but a loss is bad. So if we don't get anything, you know, we need a good or bad. We're sitting in the neutral, so that's fine.
We're not sitting in neutral. We just lost a down.
Point.
Ball's still on the 30.
Point, but we can still make progress here.
Well, we can. We just have, you know, three more tries. Two more tries.
Two more tries. Yeah,
three more tries.
Second and 10. Let's go.
That's three more tries. Another handoff. Going absolutely nowhere.
Oh, that looked like possibly a yard.
Ooh, a yard.
Well, yeah, a yard's a yard. You're not going to diss it, are you?
It's obvious that punching up the middle is not going to be a very good viable option for them.
No.
The linebackers plugging up the holes that the linemen are trying to create. I'll give them credit, though.
I will give them credit. They do well.
I got $10 on my outside handoff right here.
Well, I think you'll meet that.
Ooh, it's going to be a pass. It was supposed to be a pass play. It's going to be a flag. Ooh.
Well, that is. You know what? I'm glad you know these flags because, you know, I'm still, you know, what, now a month or so into it? I'm still trying
to
figure
those
out. I can
it's not an offside because that's on the offense.
I can usually call a holding or maybe a false start, but you know, on you got more experience on that than I do,
that's
fine. I learn as I go.
Years of watching NFL has really taught me something. There are 1,000 different ways to call an offsides penalty or encroachment penalty or neutral zone infraction. Yeah, it's going to be 4th and 5 for the Caston Comets. They're going to bring out the punt team. I don't know who's going to be punting for Caston. Usually it was James Keel and it was Phoenix Singleton.
I think it's going to be James this time around. It's number 86. That's him.
Yep.
He's had some decent kicks.
Oh, he's also had a fumble in the
point.
Touchdown area.
But we're
end zone.
Not
wow.
Putting him there yet. We're going to have him kick it.
Well, that was a nice. That was a nice kick. Then yeah, it was.
That's farther than I've seen most of his kicks so far.
About 40 yards right there.
It's all right. That's going to sit at about the 29, probably.
Going to put him deep in the Knox territory.
You know, we'll take whatever we can to keep him pushed back to prevent them from scoring.
It's all about the defense.
Oh, yeah, and we got it.
Oh no, I feel like the scores of the past five games.
Well, I'm not going to jinx this yet, but I'm going to say this. So far, this first quarter is looking pretty good considering in the past
we had one drive.
No, but you think about it, at this kind of
fumble
marker, we would have
fumble.
That.
That's Caston's ball.
Nice.
It's a nice fumble recovery. I don't know who that was.
I'm not so sure.
I don't want to say who it was. I want to say it was number 77, but I'm pretty sure it might not have been.
If that was 77, that would have been
Chris Smith.
Yeah. He sports another number occasionally. Which number is that? Is that 58, maybe?
I do not know.
I don't remember.
I don't know that one. All I know is you didn't know who number four was.
Yeah, I know.
Which is kind of disappointing. That's another handoff on the inside, getting absolutely nowhere like usual.
Whoa.
Well, you just can't keep going up the middle if you just... If you, they wasted an entire drive going right up the middle.
They do what they know, and that's about
that's
it.
True. Haven't tried anything else, though. They've had...
We've attempted passing in pass games. It didn't turn out that well.
I know. It'll be second and nine for the Castleton Comets. Another inside handoff. History repeats itself, Dakota. History repeats itself.
How so?
Did you not just see what just happened?
Oh, I thought you meant like in a more diverse level, not in like this is the exact same thing that happened the last play. Level.
Yes, not last play, last drive.
Last drive, last play.
Potato, potato.
Exactly. You get the idea. Usually you can compare my words to something someone smart would say and it comes out perfect.
It's going to be the I formation.
Is it?
Yeah.
Look at that.
Oh, see?
He's going to try something new. He's going to go for it.
Try something new and you get a couple more yards than what you're used to. Isn't that right?
Yeah.
It's called off. Variety.
Variety. That's a good one.
Hopefully we can score at least a few points this game. I would love to see a win for the Castle Comets. Bring them up. Three wins.
I would be ecstatic to see a win.
They've won against Triton and West Central. They have... Yep. Coach Jones, the head coach for Castle Comets, used to coach here at Knox.
And our number three, Phoenix Singleton, used to play for Knox a long time ago.
Oh, a long time ago. Ever since elementary.
Yep. We got him now.
That's going to be a first down for the Castle Comets.
Nice, nice, nice.
The crowd's getting fired up now.
Yeah. I always find it funny, usually when we're up here commentating for these games, we're on the opposite team's area for these. So yeah, we get to hear their perspective of the game, and it's kind of funny.
Usually it's very violent.
Oh, yeah, definitely. We are welcomed into the playing field, then ridiculed by the fans.
That's true. It wasn't as bad as the soccer sectionals.
Oh, boy.
No, it wasn't Cassie. It was Rochester versus North Miami.
Yeah.
North Miami's fans were getting a little...
into it.
Nah, I wouldn't even say that. I would say... Oh, that's a nice run by number seven, Tate Cowell.
Nice. Way to go, Tate.
Bring him right deep in the red zone of the Knox territory. It's going to be first and goal.
That's going to work.
First and goal on
Let's
the
go.
Knox's nine? Yes, nine.
Yeah. Let's go. Let's get that point. Let's get that touchdown. Come on.
We have not scored since the Pioneer game, which is the one where we had to cut out because of rain.
That was one fun time.
That was not fun at all. I don't know what you're talking about.
I was
about.
Having a blast.
I was not. I was afraid we were going to get sued or something. Get our cameras taken away because we obviously don't know. And then we got our anti-rain equipment, otherwise known as an umbrella.
That was the best thing that we've ever been given.
But they treat us well at RTC.
Oh, yeah, they do. But now we got the nice sanctity of our own press box.
It's not our own press box.
It's not, but we get our own little corner, and it's pretty nice instead of standing outside.
Yeah, staying outside in the, you know, cold wind blowing.
Yeah. Oh, we'll be sitting 2-6.
Second and six. They at least can get 3 points out of this.
Yeah.
Unless, you know, we choke, which, you know, I would prefer us not to do.
I don't think we would.
No, I just want 6 points on the board right now.
That'd be nice.
Just stop promptly on the line, brought back. We lost about two?
Maybe. Let's go for a pass.
I'm good. Lost a three.
Let's go for a pass. That would be pretty okay right now.
Well, it wasn't even a loss. Oh, they had forward progression. Knox's defense doing a really good job playing off those holes that Caston's trying to run through in the middle.
They are.
This is why I want to see an outside handoff.
Hang on, oh, hang nice on, pass. We're working. There we go.
That was an incomplete.
That pass was heading straight for number 12, Zach Conrad. Incomplete. It's a good try, though.
A timeout for Comets.
Yeah, and with that timeout, we're going to take a quick break right here, and we'll be right back at you. All right, welcome back. About 5 minutes left on the clock there.
It's 4th and 5 for the Comets. They're going to go for it.
That's what I like to see. I'm a big risk taker, as we all know.
I just want points.
Me too, but you know, it works.
Nice
always
pass.
Go for pass, and it's, come on. Incomplete.
Oh, incomplete.
Was that going to, who was that going to?
I was going to Zach Conrad again.
I figured it was Conrad, but I didn't see him.
Going to do an outside fade for him, but. Trying to use his tallness as 6'5".
That looked perfect. But now it's going to turn back over to the Redskins.
The ball is deep in the red zone, though. They're going to be on their own 5.
Well, you know, the farther out they are, the better for us it is. Our defense is pretty rocking, so, I mean.
It'd be nice if we can get a fumble here or an interception. I don't want them to punt it out.
No. Scramble.
That's some good ground. No idea who was on that tackle, though. It was a big clump of people.
It was looking like morning breakfast with scrambled eggs.
You have a window seal beam right in front of you. I don't even know if you can see that.
Well, you know, my 50-yard line's a bit blocked. But other than that, I can see pretty okay.
I'll fill you in when we get there.
All right.
We'll play the blind test where you just close your eyes and I'll tell you exactly what's happening.
All right, and I'll try and see if I can provide any good speaking of words for that.
Well, if you can't do it with your eyes open, you can't do it with your eyes closed.
Oh, interception! The number 8, that's Blake Albright.
Blake Albright bringing it down to their 20-yard line. That was a nice play by number 8.
That was awesome. All right. Let's go. Let's get some points.
That was a good field position already on there in the red zone.
All right, our defense has been playing really good now for offense.
Our defense has been good since we started. We just haven't been capitalizing on the offensive side of the ball.
Yeah, but now if our offense can shake the bugs out of their head, then maybe we can get.
I've never heard that analogy in my life.
I tend to make them up as I go. I like to be different.
Make your own analogies.
Yeah.
Oh, it was a nice
counter. Where was they? Oh.
I don't know who that is. That's Knox's ball.
That's Knox. Well, we had a good thing going. That got stopped.
He must have got hit pretty hard. That ball was flying.
Yeah, that was.
Could have been classified as a pass.
It could have been. That went far.
You know, if it wasn't, you know, in front of the line of scrimmage. And if it was forward, but, you know, it was backward. And it was still. I just want to say it's high, all right?
All right. Okay. We'll call it that.
So we back and forth defense has been making all the plays for both teams.
We can't get a stroke of good luck here.
A nice handoff. They're going to get 4 yards out of that.
Probably sitting about 16, maybe.
That would be a 1 yard gain. That's not.
Look, I'm trying to make you sound good here, so if you butcher yourself, that's all you.
I do butcher myself a lot.
I'm sorry. I just want to help.
Another outside handoff to number 20.
They're favoriting that handoff.
It's going to be a first down. Ran out of bounds. He's chased out of bounds, but caught the end.
Well, I'm glad you caught that. I got the wooden pole in front of my face.
Want to play the game now?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, here we go.
All right.
We got a person going up to the ball.
Oh, man, they do that in football. Somebody's got to go for a ball. That's the whole point of the game. carrying the ball from
shotgun
one to the
formation.
Other. Shotgun? That's probably on
pistol.
The pass.
No, I think it's pistol.
No, it's,
no,
pistol?
It's not.
Is it?
No.
You're not relaying to me accurate information.
I'm trying. I'm trying to get.
I can't do it.
Oh, he's on the run.
The crowd is cheering. 50. Obviously, something is happening. What's going on? What happened?
I got stuck on formations. I didn't know if that what kind of formation that was. I tried to sound smart. I did not sound smart at all. In fact, it sounded stupid.
Did they get another first down?
Oh, yeah, I said that.
Oh, I didn't want to get up to that. Why couldn't you just told me to keep my eyes closed?
Well, keep your eyes closed.
Okay. How are we doing?
Doing great.
Fantastic.
Everything's going great.
Well, you know,
Knox we just got a safety.
Knox's crowd
we have 2
is
points.
Making quite an uproar. And wait, we actually did.
That was actually a gain of nothing. Oh. That was a gain of 1.
Okay,
actually.
I can see now, so I'm a... Chris Howard's right down.
Second and nine.
Oh, we're rocking about 2 minutes and 30 minutes. 2 minutes
two,
and 30
2 minutes
seconds.
And 30 minutes.
2 minutes and 30 seconds in the first quarter. For the first time in the Wild, so far neither team scored. For our games, anyway.
It's a nice play by Knox. It was a nice little...
You gotta hand it to them. They got their...
They got the run game down. I haven't seen their passing game yet, but one play. They've only done one play passing. So, oh yeah, that was the interception.
Oh yeah, it was.
And then we promptly fumbled the ball right after.
And we can't just get a good thing going for it.
No, we can't. Another handoff.
For a handoff.
They're gonna be stopped. They're trying to push them.
Pile.
Be fourth in inches.
Chris Smith is definitely getting in there on these stops. Heard his name called a lot on the announcements lately. Or, yeah, the speaker. Yeah, whatever you want to call the guy in the press box that shouts out words to the fans.
Annoying.
Point.
The QB hold. Oh, he definitely
got
a first down on that.
Right. Defense needs to tighten up here, but they're gaining yards and they're gaining fast.
Clock's not taking out for some reason. I don't know why. Oh, because they're moving up the chains. That's why.
Yeah.
Totally forgot about that rule.
They got to catch up with the chains before they keep the clock going.
They can't just keep doing that. I don't know why I forgot that for some reason.
That's okay. We all forget things.
I know baseball a lot better than I know football.
Oh, handoff.
Like usual. Love it. Get about 3 yards out of that. Casey Ault on the stop on that one. Casey Ault's been doing really well this season.
Yeah, he has. He's been on the majority of most of my blabbings on this commentary.
You do a lot of that.
Entire season for it, yeah.
He's on both sides of the ball. So is the quarterback, Brady Hartman.
Brady Hartman. I can guarantee you that in every single film that I've commentated over, you can at least find their names in there at least 5 times each or more.
You just try to keep going. I think he's just trying to keep going. Like he didn't know he was down or something.
Did some kind of side flip there. Or he bounced off and
he thought he was okay.
Put him down.
Can we get official review? No, we don't have those? All right.
No, we don't got one.
We have cameras.
We do, but we're not cool.
We're not cool. 23 seconds in the first quarter.
Man, this first quarter really drove by.
I know. We're rolling it. Rolling the clock. We're going to get about one more playoff.
Let's see where that gets anybody.
Violent motion right there.
Going for a pass. Nope.
He's scrambling.
Couldn't find
outside
anyone.
The pocket. Still
throwing
he's
out.
Above the line of scrimmage. He's brought down.
Whoa, brought down hard. All right, and that's going to put an end to the first quarter. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in to RTC TV.
Okay.
All right, welcome back to RTC TV. My name, in case you forgot, is Dakota Hayden, alongside with Matt Exeter, and we are in the second quarter of tonight's football game between the Comets and the Redskins. Well, what do you think for the second quarter, Maddox?
I just want to see more points.
That would be nice, considering more the points. Score is tied 0-0.
No, I don't want to see points from them. I want to see points of us.
Well, of course, but I don't know. As long as we're not losing by like 20, I'm pretty confused.
They're almost in our red zone. I don't like that.
We'll get them.
The only people allowed in our red zone are us. There's a holding, a block in the back.
Where is it?
Touchdown, but they're bringing that back. Promptly bringing that back. Let's see what they call this here.
I'm hoping good for us. Because I don't like it when the other team takes an early lead. And that's not even an early lead. It's the second quarter. A decent lead. A lead in general.
Do you know what that penalty was?
It was for something in the back, wasn't it?
No, it was a holding penalty.
Was it?
Was it?
Was it blocking the back? What was
it?
Did I get something
like this,
and you didn't?
Oh, you like that? Okay, never mind. It's blocking the back.
I got it then.
You did get it.
Look at me. I'm learning.
All I saw was his hands go down, so I didn't know if he was going like this or like this.
Okay.
I know you couldn't see that anyone else, but there's a prompt difference between a holding penalty and a blocking the back penalty.
Especially in the sign language that we do use for football out here.
I was looking at you. I wasn't looking at the ref.
I know. I am so dashing.
QB's going to keep it.
He's trying to get out of there.
Oh, he is.
That was a nice tackle. He got destroyed. It was number 21 and 53 on that one. Trenton Howard and Ephraim Mosqueda.
Singleton.
Is that Singleton down there?
Yeah, Phoenix Singleton getting revenge.
Oh, I get me at number 53 and 3 mixed up because I only see the 3. So
use your eyes. You have glasses.
You know, there's also a wooden pole in front of me, so I'm trying to maneuver my head around.
Yeah, but you knew it was a block in the back penalty.
I did, because I saw it. That's going to be a timeout. We're going to take a short break here for a quick second. All right, and welcome back to RTC TV. Still stuck 0-0, about 11 minutes left for the second quarter.
Well, on the bright side, I got fries.
That is a good perk to have. I'm not going to tell you where they're from, though, because we have a sponsor.
That was pass interference. Offensive pass interference. Not a foul? No foul on that one?
Nope.
Count on the interception right there. That's the second one tonight. There's been a lot of offensive errors tonight.
Yep. And I kind of just said that because I didn't exactly hear what you said, so I just agree with you, whatever.
Two fumbles, two interceptions, been a lot of offensive errors tonight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Surprisingly not on our end for once.
Well, two of them. Or one of them was ours.
Yeah, and the rest were theirs. So it worked out for us. You know, 1-3 ratio.
We're working. Let's hope we can get out of this red zone here.
Your matter, handoff.
Safety.
It's not 6 points, but it's points, and I don't like it. We need some.
Preferably three.
Preferably more than that.
Preferably just points, please.
Oh, yeah, that'd be beneficial to
I'll settle with two.
All of our cause. I'd settle for one, actually, you know, considering we've racked up zero on the board the past three games in the past.
Five games.
No, we scored points at Laville.
Do you really count that?
I like to have some dignity in my team. Yes, I do count that.
All right.
I count everything that we do.
And we haven't scored in 4 weeks. And then a week before the one that you're talking about.
Yeah.
There you go. I did like LaVille, though, when we went to LaVille and we did that.
Yeah, that was fun until it got really cold. But then again, all our games are fun until they get really cold.
Well, LaVille was really nice to us, and they gave us pizza.
They were.
And they were really cool dudes.
Yeah.
You get to meet a lot of new people when you do this job.
You do. You do. It's kind of nice.
Some people you just never meet in general.
Yeah, because you would they're always in the press box and you never see them, but you get to branch out through here. And then everyone else kind of just looks at you and just like, what are they doing with all those bags full of cameras and stuff?
Unless you go to Culver.
Yeah, unless
Culver.
You go to Culver.
All right. When we went to Culver, I did not see one person smile.
Nope.
Didn't see, like, there was no emotion. It was homecoming. They had no emotion.
It was pretty sketchy up there in their press box, too.
I'm not trying to talk bad about Culver, but...
Oh, of course not, but, you know, it was kind of
creepy. Orange and black, Halloween colors, just not me.
Yeah. Kind of brought the place down a little bit. That was a kick by number 20, Brady.
That was almost good.
That was a fumble, wasn't it?
That was a fumble, but it's their ball.
Yeah, I mean... I thought I saw a fumble. There's a lot of wood in my face right now.
We can move over.
I can't because I'm kind
of
plugged in.
Oh, yeah, you're kind of plugged in right to the camera.
Yeah.
Well, I can move over.
You can move over.
Woo!
Okay, you go.
Another inside handoff. He's breaking free.
Oh, he's open there.
A nice run.
Took out his legs.
It'd be a Knox first down.
Take out his legs. Eventually, he won't be able to walk. That's good for us.
That's a little rude.
I want to win.
I don't want to be the sole responsibility of a person's injury. Oh,
depends on the situation,
down,
I guess.
Right before the first down. It'll be second and one.
All right, we'll give it to the Redskins. They do know how to move the ball.
Yeah, they've been marching up pretty fast. They had a little rough start at the beginning of the first quarter, but, I mean, it really picked up after a little while.
They definitely... He's
pushing up again.
They are definitely... They look like they know what they're doing now. No, I don't think we were too much ready for that, though. Excuse me. So our defense is... it's Holton, but it's getting pushed back, so I don't know.
I got 20 bucks on the same exact play right now, right here.
I'm not a gambling man.
I am. Same exact play.
What works once usually succeeds in the second attempt as well.
That's true.
They love it. Oh, come on, Comets. Don't let them get any more points than two. Come on.
It's going to be second and four. Or second and, yeah.
And they're trying to push him back.
It's pretty stopped. You know, stop that. Pretty, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, I get you.
Wasn't that bad.
Players are getting a little bit rough with each other down there. I notice often, like, the sides are just...
These two schools do not get along with each other.
I wouldn't think they would. There's only a handful of schools we actually get along with.
That's true. We're just a small school and everyone else is bullies.
Yeah. We're the underdogs. Almost all the time.
The underdogs are just... I don't want to say that. Never mind.
Okay.
Stop myself there.
I'll let you sit with that one. You know, we don't have pack stands over there supporting the Comets tonight, but I wouldn't blame them. It's like an hour drive to get out here to Knox, but there are a nice handful of people out there showing support for the Comets, so I appreciate them.
It's about a fourth of the bleachers filled up. I mean, that's not that bad.
And we definitely have our number one fan, Micah Paul, out there giving all this support to us.
Micah. Shock the nation, Micah. Shock the nation. God. He does that a lot.
He's great. And just to think, he's only been here 2 years.
He's already better than half his classmates supporting their school.
He's been to all our games.
He's got school spirit, I'm giving that.
Oh, he does.
Ooh, push out of the way. It's going to be on the goal line.
Okay, I can't think of the word for it. Help me out here. But it's when we hold them at the goal. What's the word for that? There's a word for that.
Goal line defense.
Goal line defense. Wow. That seems really generic. I should have known that.
I don't know why you didn't know that.
But we've done this before. We've been able to hold them back. But yeah, there's going to be a timeout, so we're going to take a short break real quick. All right, welcome back. Still 0-2.
Goal line defense.
Yeah, we're goal still holding that goal line defense back there. We've done it before. We'll do it again. Several games in the past, we've been pretty good at doing that. Although there was that one game where we got screwed over when we were trying to make them score. But yeah, as you can see, that's going to be a touchdown for the Redskins. That's going to be 6 points for them, and no points for us yet. And well, yeah, there you go. We're behind.
It is what it is.
It is what it is. They got a bell. They ring a bell when they score a point.
Hey, Maddox, did you know every time a bell rings, a Knox player scores a touchdown?
It must not ring that often.
Oh, get wrecked.
I did not know that.
I was trying to, the reference I was making, never mind. I was going to say I was going to do a reference to It's a Wonderful Life for that one.
You're pretty good at references.
I know, I try.
You try a little too hard sometimes. But
I got to do something when football's not exactly my forte like you.
Well, I mean, I don't know everything about it. As you can see, I blatantly mistaked a holding penalty or a block in the back penalty for a holding penalty.
Everyone makes mistakes, Maddox, but I do acknowledge that your knowledge is better than mine when it comes to this sport.
I just watch a lot of football.
Although, I bet I have you beat at volleyball.
Oh, I bet you do. I do not know anything about volleyball.
All right, Knox is setting up to kick the ball off to the Comets.
I was asking the our football players what their favorite NFL team was, and I got pretty disappointed when I heard three of them said the Patriots.
Oh, that would have put me in a bad mood straight off.
I feel like I don't think I want to ask anyone else, because I'm afraid everyone else is going to say that too.
Yeah, that was a nice kick.
Got a few Colts fans in there. I mean, that's pretty nice. I mean, Colts have kind of fallen off the edge of the earth recently, but
yeah, you used to hear a lot about them. Nowadays, you just kind of.
I don't know if he's going to bring it back.
Just kind of out there.
Ball is spotted on the 32 or the 33. I don't know where the. Yeah, there he is. Block in the back.
I was going to say words. I don't remember my words.
Oh, yeah, I do. Comets got sectionals next week, and unfortunately, we won't be covering them, but I do know that they drew Triton, which Triton, we've beaten them in the past, and I do say we will
do
it again.
One of the two wins that we have right now.
Yeah, Triton, and the other one's West Central, I do believe.
I think we can beat Triton again.
I hope we can beat Triton so we can move on to at least the second round of sectionals.
Oh yeah, I definitely think we can make it to the second round.
I think the if we win against Triton, or when we win against Triton,
exactly,
we will play the winner of either South Newton or Southwell. I'm pretty sure it's South Newton. South Newton and Northfield.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
And both teams are exceptionally good.
We can beat them. We're the underdogs. You ever heard about the Underclass Hero?
Those are in movies.
Well, who's to say real life isn't just a big old movie?
You're not a movie star.
But I'm the main character. In mine.
This isn't a movie. This is real life.
Okay, what do you want me to say? I'm trying to be inspirational and optimistic here, and you're just really shutting me down here, man.
I'm just trying to put it out like how it is.
We can beat them. I have faith. I had all the faith in the world going in the Pioneer game. And look where that got us.
Really, I do remember hearing you say something right there in the Pioneer game that really turned the tide.
I said nothing controversial about
myself.
You
said something a little controversial in that video. I remember that. I remember pointing it out to you, and I remember making fun of it to you, and I remember trying to make the football players see it so they can promptly beat you up. I was going to say something really bad there.
Well, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to say I'm not going to say what it is, so that way the viewers can go and find it, and we can get more views on the video.
They were going to go do it, and now they're not going to do it because they're going to spite you. They're going to be like, this nerd can't tell me what to do. I'm doing my own time.
You know, I was really happy starting this game off. Now you're making me a little bit mad. Can I fire you?
I'm joking.
I don't think you can.
Well, we got 7 minutes and 30 seconds in the 7 quarters, 2nd and 14. Jinx.
No, you owe me a soda. I'm very thirsty right now. Those fries really took away. I don't have any moisture in my body anymore.
There's a pristine way to go about things when it comes to commentating, Maddox. Which, of course, we're all professionals here. Quality commentary.
That looks like a timeout on the field by the comics. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you right back in a minute. And welcome back. I'd like to make a grammatical correction on myself. It's the Comets, not the Comics.
It's not grammatical.
I'm going to say it's grammatical and hope I sound smart in the process. I did not, I know.
Not if anyone knows what the word grammatical means.
I'm pretty sure most of our viewers do.
What?
I'm pretty sure most of the viewers do.
But you don't?
I'm only in 12th grade English.
All right, we're back.
When did they get 9?
23.
Did I not pay attention?
Ball
and they got
1.
Whoa.
Did I not pay attention and they hit a field goal?
What?
I now notice that it's 0-9. And I'd like to question where that extra point came from.
The PAT after the touchdown?
Yeah, they got that?
Yes, they got that.
I didn't see them get that.
The PAT?
Yeah.
You're blunder than I thought.
Maddox, this is the first time in a long time I've been in a press box. The mirrors are really screwing with my vision. Mirrors, there's no mirrors in here.
I meant windows.
Here at RTC, we don't know the difference between mirrors and windows.
I'm just stupid.
What's see-through?
See-through?
You've got glasses on. Are those mirrors?
No, these are HD definition glasses.
HD.
Total geek wear, my friend.
I was going to take it on their own, or the Comets 37. 36.
Let's play good defense, guys. Come on.
Another hand.
What
off.
Is that? Someone stop him. Come on. Someone, please.
Okay, that was a tad ridiculous. It was a good run, but that was a tad ridiculous.
This is the part where we start breaking bones and just claiming their accidents.
Yeah. I gotta try and keep calm here and keep an inside voice.
You never keep calm.
I'm not outside. I can't start yelling. I don't. You know, there's other people in here, and I don't want to screw them up either. They're just pushing. Step in time. Step in time, Maddox. Step in time. They were just squaddling along there. And that's going to be another timeout, I think, was called on the field. Was there a timeout?
I don't know where you got timeout from.
I swore I heard a timeout.
Nope.
Oh, I'm losing it, Maddox. I'm getting too old. My ears are going. My eyes are going. My mind's going.
Your eyes have been going.
You know what? You might as well just throw me in a casket and ship me off.
I was thinking about it, but you don't have life insurance, so.
Man.
Another handoff on the right side.
We gain anything?
Bring him up 3 yards. Can you see?
Kinda. I did see enough to see that I think that was Phoenix on the tackle, number 3.
I just realized this is probably the last game that we're going to be covering.
For football? Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure too. But you know, there's a lot of kids on the casting team that, you know, I know a lot, and they scored again, so I'm really kind of mad. I'm trying to get deep anyway.
Dang it!
That's gonna bring them up to 15 points.
That's not cool. Yo, hold up. Wait a minute. Take a step back.
Stop. Wait a minute.
All right, now I'm paying attention. So if they get the extra
maybe
point.
Last time you were too infatuated with the bell.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. Yeah, that was a good one though. I'll remember that. Remember, Maddox. Every and time a bell rings, kick? A Knox player makes a freaking extra point.
Oh boy, I'm ticked.
Yeah, I do realize that this is probably going to be the last game that we cover for football, yeah. Which is kind of sad because I love just being here with the football team. I love everyone on the football team. Yeah. I love even the managers, like, and even one of the people that film forecasting for the actual team.
Yeah, it's all
Mr.
fun.
Pete Duvall.
He's great.
He's just a little kid and he knows what he's doing.
That's what I love about this job. It's fun hanging out with everyone. And stuff like that. And that's why I can't wait to start up basketball.
You doing basketball?
When that comes around, yeah.
Commentating?
Yep.
You're going to commentate it?
I will.
You're not going anywhere.
You can't get rid of my lovely voice.
I wish I could.
I know. A lot of people tell me that.
Mom.
Mom. Another nice kick by Knox.
That's a really nice kick. Oh,
what are you doing, Blake?
He's going to pick it up. He's going to run with it right into a defender. Straight into him.
You calling me blind? He's red. You literally can't not see them.
Can't not see them.
Well, what do you think the Bulls go after?
Huh?
The Bulls?
Well, that's a common misconception. They don't actually get angered by the color red.
Have I been lied to?
Yes, you have. Bulls are colorblind.
It's the motion of the flag, isn't it? Okay.
Bulls are colorblind.
I knew that.
Yeah. Of course he did.
All right, so it's 4 minutes and like around 30 seconds left in the second quarter.
As soon as I start calling him out, he tries to change the subject.
We're taking the offensive now, 1st and 10. Hand off.
Absolutely nowhere.
We're
loss
trying.
Of two?
We're
loss
trying.
Of two. Is that all that matters in your book?
Sure, you might not get a gold star and a trophy for trying, but you know what? At least you attempted.
I'll give you that.
I mean, You can try anything once.
It is really warm in this press box, which is which really helps.
I was going to ask, why are you complaining, considering we've been frozen in place before?
We have been frozen in place before. It was not very nice at all. It was not comfortable. No. That was the time I wish I brought, like, six extra pairs of clothes this time, and we're sitting in a heated press box, so I'm...
You're nice and cozy without them.
That was bad.
Wooden pole, what happened? Huh? I got a wooden pole, what happened?
Well, at first he got stopped, and then he probably got picked up off his feet and slammed to the ground.
Who did?
I'm pretty sure that was number seven?
Seven?
Tate. I don't know if that was number seven or not.
Yeah, we'll call it.
We have a one in three chance of that being right. Either it was number three, it was number seven, or it was number 40.
You know, if we're wrong, someone will call us out on it. Or not. I mean, I don't know.
We usually call ourselves out on it.
Yeah.
Or usually I do it to you when I'm doing the camera.
Yeah. But you don't got the camera this time. This time,
we're all together.
Other co-commentator Galen Rensselaer is taking up the camera this
number
time.
Number one on their team just ran to our coach and about got leveled out. I don't know if I was the only one that saw that, but...
There was a player that almost ran out to Coach Jones.
No, he did. He ran into Coach Jones, and he about fell. Like, Coach Jones is a big dude.
Yeah, he is. He is. Like, muscly dude. Was it one of the Knox players or one of the Caston players?
No, it was one of the Knox players.
Oh, he should have leveled him out.
You can't do that. No, you can't do that.
That would have been funny. It was a nice kick by 86, James. Grab his feet, take him down.
Throwing over the shoulder backwards. Tripped up on the play. First and 10 for the Redskins on Caston's 40. 43. I did not see.
That's fine. At least we went in the vicinity of where it's at. I'm going to say 42.
Oh. As soon as the... Sometimes, man. Oh, it was a double handoff.
That was a gain, wasn't it?
Yep. Gain of six.
Blasted wooden poles in my face.
Well, coming down to the last 2 minutes of the first half here.
Yeah. Hopefully we can make a play here, maybe interception. Maybe there'll be a fumble and we pick it up. Maybe we score 6 points. Maybe. Maybe get another 2-point conversion. Maybe score some points. Maybe get rid of that zero on the board.
Ball's going to be marked down to 28.
Maybe do something. Maybe not let Knox score again. That'd be pretty good, thanks.
2 minutes left to go here.
Knox is going
to
get the ball right after this half.
Yeah, I know. Because, actually, I don't know. But they got it, whatever.
Sure.
Minute 30 left on the clock. And it's throwing that deep.
Deep pass.
Intercept. Come on. Oh, incomplete. He kind of tripped over his own 2 feet there.
I disagree with that call completely.
Yeah. Although the Redskins, their crowd doesn't seem to be. They got cowbells galore down there.
Galore. I don't know what those horns are called that they use in soccer, but... Don't even try. Yeah, I don't know.
I won't. We'll shut up about it. Yeah, it looks like off to the side here we got their band setting up to do maybe a halftime show. That'll be fun.
Yeah, too bad we don't get that on film.
Yeah, we don't need to.
Yeah, I really don't care.
You see, there's always an aspect to it, Maddox, that
things you catch on film, you got to leave some stuff out so that way people actually come to the stuff and see it with their own eyes. Because
maybe they wanted to come to this stuff and they just couldn't. Maybe they have work or something and they have to watch it at home. Maybe that's this because this isn't live.
Okay, so maybe it's not their fault. Okay, that's understandable.
And you're just trying to cut them out of the stuff.
Boy, you're reading too far into this.
I mean, it's kind of rude.
Okay.
They're doing stuff offside.
Okay. Are you happy?
No, because it was an unfair. Unfair penalty called against us.
I saw that wasn't cool at all, but at least they haven't scored again.
Another penalty on the field. Try to see what this one is.
Was it called for?
Hopefully it's not pass interference, because apparently anything's pass interference for these refs.
Well, that is true.
Do you know what that one was?
I didn't catch it. I got a pull.
It's a clipping penalty.
Is it clipping?
It's clipping.
It was on Knox, wasn't it? Because I see the comments moving that way.
Yeah, that was chop block, clipping.
Aight. Yeah, that's right. Back it up, boyo.
Shut up. It's a really big penalty for him.
It helps us.
Well, I didn't say it was a bad thing. I just said it was a really big penalty.
I know what you were saying.
Going to force him to go for a pass. A
that's complete.
Blast.
Come on, get him. Come on.
Bring it all the way back up to the four.
All right. You know, the penalty didn't seem to hold them back too much. Because they kind of just
chop
gave.
Blocking's a serious penalty, but that doesn't mean you can't bounce back from it.
They just
timeout
did.
Timeout called.
There was a timeout?
Yep.
Well, with that timeout, we're going to take a short break here, and we'll be right back with you guys. All right, and welcome back. We got about a minute left on the clock here for the second quarter.
Ball's going to be on the Caston's 5. He's going to run it straight in.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, why?
I mean, that decent play, I guess. It scored them points. I'm not happy.
You're never happy.
No, I am.
Not now.
Well, not now, of course, but I had coffee.
Make sure you watch this PAT attempt.
I'm watching it. I'm going to call it that. It's going to be good. Watch me. I'm a genie. See, hear that? It's a bell ringing, so they're going to hit a PAT.
Oh.
I'm a genie.
I was almost blocked by number 7.
Come on, Comets. Let's get some points scoring here.
1:02 left in the first half.
Don't make Maddox right and make it be a fifth week in a row. Come on.
Maddox was right. Maddox didn't call this.
No, but you've been saying that, and I've been correcting you by saying something about the LaVille game, but now you will be right in it being 5 weeks in a row.
Yeah, 5 weeks in a row plus one.
Come on, we need a good run into sectionals. We don't need a losing streak into sectionals. But I would be okay with if we did have a losing streak in the sectionals, and then we went to state.
You've got some high hopes for us, don't you?
I try and be optimistic.
I know. First things first, win sectionals.
Right.
Then you win regionals.
Right.
Then you win semi-state.
Yeah.
Then you win state.
Right.
Then you win nationals. No, I'm kidding.
I believe one day we could go that far.
Nationals?
Maybe not us, but maybe the school.
I mean, maybe. Not us. It's not going to be us.
You never know that.
Have you ever seen the...
That was a really nice kick.
Another fumble.
All right, let's continue.
Number 40, Casey Ault.
Good old Casey with that run back.
Bring it up to the 18-yard line.
All right, would you like to continue, Negative Nancy, on how it would be impossible for us to do nationals one year, one day, maybe not in our lifetime?
Have you ever seen the number one team in the nation for high school?
Yeah.
You've watched some of their stuff?
Uh-huh. We can take them.
From California, from Los Angeles?
Yeah, we can take them.
Or Las Vegas. I think it's Los Angeles. No, it's Las Vegas.
We can take them. Maybe not.
They play schools from Hawaii.
Maybe not us, but that doesn't mean, like, say, 50 years down the line, we got, like, a...
Oh, it's a drop pass.
Like a prime team to just completely kick butt. I mean, we do enough butt kicking out there already.
I mean, scoreboard really shows.
Yeah, not now, but usually. At least our defense.
Yeah, our defense is pretty well.
Pretty well. They're great.
There's 23 points on the board right now.
They're great when they want to be.
Oh, you didn't say that. That changes everything.
When they're not level-headed?
You know, it's kind of rocky. But when they are, they're Tony the Tiger great. Not sponsored.
I wish we were, though.
That'd be awesome. And sponsored by Frosted Flakes.
You wouldn't hear me commentate. You would just hear me crunching down just a bunch of eating noises. I love Frosted Flakes.
Or Honey Bunches of Oats.
Oh,
I love Honey Bunches of Oats.
And back to the game.
No, I'm still thinking about like Honey Bunches of Oats, bro. I don't know what you're up with.
3-7 for the Comets.
20 seconds left. I don't think they're going to get on our staff off. I think they're just going to let this one run.
Yeah, then we'll sit through halftime. Actually, and I'm hoping to come back.
I'm going to get one more playoff. Probably going to be like a Hail Mary or something. If they go for a run, I'm going to cry.
Oh, so. Please. Please, and let it work.
Be a run up the middle.
Let it work. Come on.
I wouldn't commentate. I'd give it to Galen again.
And that's going to be the end of the second quarter. Well, thank you all for tuning in to RTC TV, and we'll be back with you guys after halftime. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to RTC TV. My name is Dakota Hayden, along with Maddox Zider, and we'll be commentating the second half of the game here tonight between the Cats and Comets and the Knox Redskins. Well, Maddox, I ought to say I kind of butchered that introduction to the second half. I apologize.
I was a little disappointed, but it's my first time, so I can't really say much.
I appreciate your sympathy, but we got the Comets kicking over to the Knox. So, yeah.
Comets kicking over to the Knox.
To the Knox.
To the Knox. There is no other Knox ever.
No, not really.
Here we go. Come here.
Oh, that kick went straight up. Who kicked that? What was it?
That was number 20, Brady Hartman, on the
Brady
kick.
Brady with the kick.
Ow.
Hit yourself?
I did with the mic. And so if there's anything interference, I apologize.
Knox going to get it on their own 45.
Which is a decent start for them, I guess. But you know,
see what the casting defense can do.
We're going to get them. Be a brick wall.
Yeah, trick play. Going to get absolutely nowhere. Not actually going to gain a yard, my bad.
It's a nice stop by number 40, Casey Ault.
So based on the last half, like, and the events that unfolded in the last half, what do you say the end score of the second half would be?
The end score of the second half? Well, I'm going to go out on a limb.
A giant limb, if you think.
A log, if you will.
An entire tree.
You know what? An oak wood tree, yeah. Ooh, pass.
Redwood.
Based that's a complete pass.
Just unfolded right here.
Okay, wait a minute. Somebody stop him. Come on. Okay, now.
Ball's out on their casting four.
Rethinking my hypothesis as about stated before.
Yep.
I'm going to say we're going to score once.
Okay.
And I'm going to be pretty happy with that. But I'm also going to say that we might lose by math, 34.
36.
Okay. Respectable score. That's fine.
I'm trying to be reasonable here.
I know you aren't. I know what you're trying to I know what you're thinking. Thinking, oh, Caston sucks. I might go there, but oh, it's a nice little play.
I didn't say it. I didn't say it. Those weren't my words.
Oh, look at that, Maddox. My prediction's already coming true.
All they need to do is score another one. Scored, you know, two extra points.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to cry myself to sleep.
I'll do that anyway.
Man. Rough night.
It'd be good.
I hit the corner. The corner. One of the posts. But still good regardless, so. It's just, it's not good.
Is there a timeout called on?
No. It's a touchdown, Dakota.
I know. I'm trying. Like, yeah. I'm really sad. I mean, we're trying, but, you know, I want to see points. And not for the other team. I want to see points for us.
I'm trying to untangle that wire right there.
Hold on.
Hopefully you don't screw anything up.
Look at me go. I'm ingenuity. I got some breathing
room. Scoot
over
and actually see the game. Well, what do you think?
Look at that. I can see clearly now. The rain
is gone.
It's
a window. Actually, it's a mirror.
Too late. I can see all obstacles in my way. All right, where are we at? They're kicking back to us.
Yep.
That's another good kick.
Put back.
That's not a good start for us.
Ball on our own eight.
We got a lot of yards to make up if we're going to get anywhere on that point that I predicted.
It's almost like an entire field.
You know.
If your calculations are correct.
Wow, it is an entire field.
Yes.
I hate it when you get smart.
You don't do it very often.
Actually, I find it comically appropriate, but, you know, you carry on. You do you, man. It's your first time on the job. I'll give you a pretty decent review afterwards.
I get review? Is this like, what am I, an app?
You are now.
What's that one really good reviewing app? Not app, site.
Yelp.
No, not Yelp. It's a different one. It's like the ones that rate movies and everyone like goes for.
Oh, I don't know.
It's the one that was just like, if this website says that it's really bad, then it's really bad. Like, there's no other option.
You're not thinking IGN, are you?
No.
Rotten Tomatoes?
Yes, that one right there.
Oh. Rotten Tomatoes has got a low scoring for most movies out there.
And they're very critical.
They are. They are.
I wonder if you put our entire football, like all of our football clips together and call it a movie. You know, what do you think it'll get on the Rotten Tomatoes score?
-3.
Is that even possible?
It is now.
It is now. Tangled up in the backfield once again. It was number 40, Casey All on the carry.
Ah, good old Casey.
So let's take a minute right here. Even though you don't know very much about football, what do you think is wrong with the Caston offense that does not allow them to score?
They're a bit repetitive, and they're easily readable because of it.
You think if they changed up what their offense was, then they'd do a lot better?
Variety, yeah.
So you're saying that we don't have variety?
We don't.
Even though Knox is on the same exact play 10 times in a row.
But somehow they're able to run it better.
Hey, it was a nice little pass there.
And they're getting more ground out of it.
Yeah.
But when we try it, we get no ground.
No, we just got ground out of it.
Well, that was a pass. I'm talking about like our running game.
Oh.
The normal?
Yeah.
Yeah. We normally don't get anything out of that. So
oh, that's exactly what I was saying.
If it doesn't work, then we try something else, which we don't a lot of the time.
Yeah, that's true.
But, like, see that pass? That worked. Do it again. But it's the fourth, so we're probably not going to. We're going to kick it back.
What do you think the weakest link in cast football is? The weakest link.
The weakest link?
That was a big foul.
You're making me pick people out here.
Look, I mean, he's playing stupid. Number 22 on their team's playing stupid. Like, oh, I didn't do anything. I don't know why you're calling that.
Oh, you did something, buddo.
I didn't just do a block in the back and to your quarterback. It's nothing. It's no big deal.
Throw them out.
They're red cards in football.
What are they doing in soccer?
What in soccer? It's in soccer.
Still called football.
That's true. There's someone booing. I don't know why. They're up 30-0. I don't know why they have to boo.
I don't know. It's Knox. Maybe they do that.
It's Knox.
We get the idea, dude.
No, he's going to keep going. Watch him. He can do it again.
No, I think he's gone silent.
I think he's had enough. I think he's finally realized that you're never going to get your point across.
Yep.
It only took him 5 yells. He realized, hey, they're not listening to me because I'm stupid.
It's fantastic. There's a handoff by Knox. It drugged down by number 3, Phoenix.
I don't know what foul this is going to be.
I didn't see. I was paying attention to Phoenix.
It's going to be a horse collar penalty. Oh, it's face mask penalty.
That is face mask. That's what that means.
Yeah.
That's one of the more obvious ones.
The most obvious one is probably an offsides penalty.
Probably, but that one's kind of given since the signal for it, you literally grab the face.
I mean, I'm learning.
All right. Knox setting up. Going for a pass. That's complete. Nice come on. There you go. Good takedown by number 21, Efren Amoskita, and number 20, right? Yeah, Brady Hartman.
Mm-hmm. The one that got plowed over.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yep, he's still in the game. Which is kind of surprising.
How so?
Because he just got blindly tackled in the back. Like, he got ran over in the back.
Was it that bad?
Oh, it was very bad. You didn't see it?
Probably wouldn't pull. Oh, there's another pass that's complete. Knox's passing game is pretty good.
Oh, Phoenix does not have any of this. He's throwing Knox players all around.
I want to see him go ham and just take him out.
I know Phoenix Singleton does not like Knox at all.
I wouldn't imagine. That's why he left.
He did leave. He did not have any nice words to say about Knox before the game. I talked to him.
Mm-mm.
I cannot say those words on the air. They call Knox. So everyone else, I mean, they're not really. They're kind of indifferent about him, but not Phoenix.
Well, he's just the only one that's got personal experience.
Yeah, that's true. And Coach Jones.
Yeah, and Jones.
I have no idea how good Knox is, like, against anyone else. I have no idea. I have never watched any of their stuff.
I haven't either. So this is all new to see how they compare to others.
Compared to us, they're pretty good, but compared to, like, you know, some good schools.
Now, if we score against them, then that's going to take them, you know, back a notch there.
Back a few notches, actually.
I'd be more than happy if we did that. It's like they're throwing. Now they're just running.
All the way up to the 3-yard line.
We're reaching about 7 minutes here in the third quarter.
Oh, man.
First and goal for Knox.
Knox's run game is really, really nice, though.
It is. It's been breaking our defense, like, all night.
outside all the way.
He's got it. Yeah, you know, I'm going quiet. I get
what?
I could say many a vulgar thing. I could screech like a banshee right now, but you know, I'm staying silent. You hear that? There's the bell.
Okay. On the count of three, you're not going to talk anymore.
All right.
Ready?
Yeah, let's go.
You're not going to talk until the... Do you want to say the end of the third quarter? Do you want to say what time?
3 minute mark.
3 minute mark?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. 3, 2, 1. All right, I'll be taking over from now on, so now I can say whatever I want. Well, I'm not sure I'll be able to say whatever I want, but I'm not going to hear his constant complaining. He's got his thumbs over his mouth because he knows he's not allowed to say anything anymore. He's going to bite his thumbs. Ooh, that looks painful. That looks really painful. Score is now 36-0. It's actually going to be 37. Because I'm pretty sure they made that PAT. I know Caston has a relatively small team compared to the rest of the, like every other school. We are a 1A school, which is like the smallest you can possibly have without being classified as a just a regular group of students, not like an actual school. We're right down there. I have no idea what Knox is. I'm pretty sure they're a 3A, which is that goes all the way up to a 6A, which is like Fort Wayne, South Bend. Schools like that, big schools that, you know, some kids don't even know all the kids in their grade. I couldn't even imagine that. That would suck a lot. But what we lack in sports, we can make up for in individuality. That's a nice run. All the way up to the 33. 31, 32, I don't know, one of those two, 31. It's gonna be first and 10 on the 31, Caston's own 31, see if they can get, start pushing up a little bit more. They've only had a couple of first downs this entire game. Fingers crossed for it. Nice pitch out. And his attack on the backfield. Lost a 3. You can face palm all you want, but you're still not going to be able to talk until that 3 minute mark. Knox's defense has been faring really well against Caston's offense. Just, you know, to be expected, our offense has been lackluster for a long time. Yeah, I can't really blame anyone. I mean, I'm not even out there on the field, so I can't really say what's wrong with them without, you know, sound like a hypocrite. A handoff to Blake Albright. And take it all the way on the outside. Then foul. I don't know what that is. It's a little. I was after the play. No idea what this call is going to be. Here comes a white hat strolling on up. A personal foul. It's going to give him to cast another first down. The ball's going to be up on the 50-yard line. About as neutral as you can possibly get here. Clock's rolling. It's going to be 5 minutes and 25 seconds. Casey's trying to push his way up. Gains about 2 yards. It's going to be second down and 8. Refs are going to keep rolling the clock. Score is still 37-0.
Knox had a really interesting halftime show. I don't really know what that was. I mean, we watched it off cam, and it was, I mean, I get what they were trying to do. It was a pretty interesting concept. I could not follow it at all. I didn't know if there was a story behind that, or they took that out of the movie, or that was like their own voice acting. I have no idea. You know, it was pretty interesting. I was thoroughly entertained. Oh, drop by number 40. He's looking ahead before he catches the ball and drops it. Would have been a nice game. That's going to make it third down and 9. You're not very happy at all. You still can't talk? You got about a minute 30 left. Yeah. I'd be pretty mad too, but you know, you wanted this, so you're going to get it. You put the newbie on for 3 minutes, and this is what he does. He just keeps talking. Dropped again. Bad pass by number 20, Brady Hartman. It was intended for number 12, Zach Conrad, but found the ground instead. Be fourth down and 9. And they're going to punt it. Bringing down 86, James Keel, which is... Oh, wait. Never mind. They're going to go for it. I thought since they brought out James Keel, they were going to be punting, because that's the only time I ever see James do anything is punt. Brady's going to keep that. It's going to be a first down. He's going to run it out of bounds. Another flag after the play. I don't know if this was... Hopefully this does not come back on the comments. Oh, they're pointing towards Knox. Another personal foul against Knox. I don't know what's going on with Knox. Handoff on the outside, number 21, Efren is going to be brought down with a 5-yard gain. It's going to be second down and 5 for the Cast of Comets. Ball's going to be on the 15, or the 13, or the 12, I don't know, 1 or 2. One, three. 3 minutes and 46 seconds, you still have 40 seconds to go before we can start talking. I know this is killing you because you love to talk. On a brighter note, it is fall break for the Cast of Comets. Fall break just started today. It's going to be a week off. Kind of sucks how it's not going to be over Halloween, the actual holiday, but a week off is a week off. In other news, they just pushed up to the 5-yard line. It's going to be first and goal, or second and 5, wow. They've got 3 minutes and 14 seconds to go to score. Actually, they have a lot more than that. They can just keep going. Hopefully they can get some points on the board. Maybe a foul. I'm going to call that false start on the offense. Going to back him up 5 yards. Going to be second down. Ball on the 11-yard line. Or it's first down, the 11. Oh, it's kind of funny how the clock stopped at 3 seconds. He still can't go. Not until they start. They're going to roll it. They're rolling. 3, 2, 1, and you.
Oh, thank God. I just wanted to say so many things. Okay, first, let's start off with those 2 passes. What was that?
I don't
okay,
know.
It was going, and then just didn't catch what? Okay, then we're over. There's a pass. What is this? Ah! Oh my gosh! I go silent for 3 minutes, and I come back to what?
Welcome back.
I'm going home.
Oh, you actually rode here with the team, so we can't do that.
Oh yeah, that's an hour back home.
Yeah, I'm not walking.
Oh my gosh! Screw that. Screw that.
Interception all the way.
I was feeling pretty good.
In the red zone.
Okay, we had those two bad passes.
Yeah.
What are you doing? And then we had it was doing
first
pretty
11.
Good. They were going through, and then that.
Look, I don't make the rules. I just follow them, all right?
And I don't play the game. I just watch it. Is that...
He picked it back up.
Just drop it. Let us take it. Please.
Did he pick it back up? I'm pretty sure you picked it back up.
No, I was just... I have a number of words to say.
Yeah?
But unfortunately, to keep this broadcast PG, I can't say any of them.
Unfortunately, to keep your job, you have to keep it PG, so...
Yeah.
Timeout.
There's Thomas. A timeout called on the field. All right, well, that'll be a timeout. We'll be back with you guys after the break. Back.
So what did you think about that interception that just happened?
You know what? I'm at peace. I looked over at our field. I see the cheerleaders trying to, you know, encourage.
Is that what makes you peace? Is that really? You trying to say something?
Way to interrupt me.
I'm not trying to interrupt you. I'm trying
you know,
to be real here.
You see the cheerleaders, you know, they're pumping up the crowd over there trying to keep their spirits up.
The crowd looks really pumped after what just unfolded in front of their eyes.
I'm trying to be positive here.
It's
really
not like they just drove an hour. Here.
Okay.
Yeah.
I see what roles we're playing right now. I'll be the positive outlooking guy. You'll be the negative Nancy.
I'm not negative.
You're definitely being negative. I'm trying to tell you how I got happiness out of the past 20 seconds of my life, and you're just shooting me down.
Hey, an incomplete pass. It's going to make it... What? It's going to make it what?
That was not 4, was it?
Did they really?
What? Wait a minute. Hold the phone up there, kid. And that was 4.
4th and 7.
Okay. Well, there's just Alt back there in receiving.
You got 4 shadows. That's really cool. I know it's because the light's pistol. Really cool.
Yeah. That is cool.
Oh, you about just got that.
Look out, look out.
Did he not just touch that?
I swore he touched that.
I don't know. It doesn't really matter.
What happens on, like, since, you know, my knowledge is lacking in this, what happens if you were to touch that?
Oh, they call it down right there.
Oh, okay.
It kills the ball.
Oh, okay. That makes
punt.
Sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's to ensure the safety of everyone on the field when there's a punt. And, you know, because the people that are receiving the punt, they have to look up. That's why they can call it fair catch when they wave their hands in the air.
Right.
So when they catch it, like, they're not allowed, if they wave their hands in the air and the refs call a fair catch,
mm-hmm.
you're not allowed to touch them.
Ah, okay.
Because if you do, that's a penalty.
Ah, okay. There's a handoff to Ephron. Oh, he ran straight through there. Nice game.
Tuck and roll, boy.
All four by Fida.
It's going to be second and eight. No, second and two. It was an 8-yard gain.
Get your numbers right there, Maddox.
55 seconds left to go in the third quarter.
Come on, rush him. Let's go. We can get that score.
Can we?
We can. It's possible.
You sure?
If we get our heads in there, it's going to work.
If our offense does some work here.
Oh, look at that. He's just straight up gains. That's going to be a first
number
down.
Number three, Phoenix Singleton on the first down.
Nice.
I know Phoenix has some cousins that go to Knox. He has some family members that go to Knox, but that really does not help his view of what Knox is.
No. And with such a big school, there's so many people that it wouldn't even matter.
I don't know, I played his cousin in baseball, when I played baseball.
Yeah?
I played him once. He was a second baseman like me.
Cool.
And then we lost 1-0, and then we came back the next game, and we beat them, I believe. We beat them. I'm not sure what the score was, but I know we beat them.
There was a handoff to number 8, Blake Albright. He's way open. Let's go. Oh, if he would have been just a tad faster, we would have had that.
He's trying his best, all right?
Okay, yeah, I know, but I'm just pointing out. That was a great game.
See,
on yards.
He's been negative, Nancy.
No, I'm not.
No, it's fine.
I'm pointing out if that guy didn't.
I get it.
That was a nice gain of yards by Blake Albright.
There you go.
All right, well, that's going to put an end to the third quarter. Thanks again, everybody, for tuning in to RTC TV. We'll be right back with you guys in the fourth quarter. All right, and welcome back to RTC TV. In case you've forgotten, my name is Dakota Hayden, and alongside with me, the one and only Matt Exciter.
That'd be really hard to forget your names in that span, though.
It would, but I'm just saying in case they were just tuning in or whatnot.
You're a very memorable guy, you know that?
Thank you. Yet I can't remember like half my family's birthdays, and it makes me feel like a total tard.
I don't know my mom's birthday. I know it's 2 days before. It's 2 days after her anniversary, because it goes A, then B. That's all I know. I don't know half my brother's birthdays.
You remember mine?
Yeah.
All right, I'll go with that. I'm not going to let you answer that. So, we're on the offensive now.
So I remember that it is it's Leif Erikson Day.
It is. That's all you really need to know.
Hinger dinger nargen.
I also share that birthday with a fellow school member.
Alexa. Cool.
Yep. Yes, I do.
Does Alexa play any sports?
She was playing volleyball.
Okay.
She didn't get enough time, and she had a lot of schoolwork, so she ended up dropping out of that. Not really dropping off, just kind of leaving. She was pretty good for what it was. I don't think she plays any others that come to mind.
I know her brother, Brock.
Plays baseball.
Would play baseball, but I'm pretty sure he's not going to play baseball, so I'm going to have to beat him up if he doesn't play baseball.
Makes sense. We'll definitely back you up on that one.
Good, thank you.
Maybe I'll talk
to outside handoff, number 21, Ephron.
Maybe I'll talk to Alexa and knock some sense into him. I don't know.
I'm pretty sure he stretched over the goal line, but that's just me.
Well, we're this close, so I'm totally expecting us to score. I hope you know that.
Oh, I am too.
I'm going to be pretty irate.
You want to do another 3 minute interval?
No, I refuse.
You want me to do a 3 minute interval?
I will. I can't.
If they don't score, I'll do a 3 minute interval of me not talking.
Okay. That's agreeable. Then everyone's going to think I'm crazy because I'll just be talking to myself. Which we all know I can do. Because I am insane.
Because you have a lot of practice.
I do. I'm lonely.
Pushed back.
They were pushed back. Comets, what are you doing? You're right there. Literally, it's right there.
You can touch it.
You can touch it. Walk it over, please. Why are you still backing up? Oh, come on. Please, 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 please. All right, here we go. Come on, second and one. Come on. Push it in. There was not.
Ball's down. Knocks his ball.
Oh my.
We did not score. I will see you back 6 minutes and 30 seconds.
Oh, I can't even describe how mad I am about that. We were right there. We could touch it. We could just gallop. And it's... Oh my... Who dropped it? I'm not even gonna ask. Oh, that was ridiculous. Okay. Yeah, level myself out here. Just a second. Okay. Alright, 9 minutes and 30 seconds left to go. 3 minutes on my own. Let's get a score. Come on. That was a complete pass by Knox. He way overshot that one. Don't know where he was going with that. Got a bit of a cannon on him. Isn't any good if it's not accurate. Alright, Knox has got a lot of ground to cover, but I got faith in our defense. This quarter, I think we can hold him back. Wants to be a handoff, and he's got a little bit of an opening there. Somebody stop him, please.
What are you doing?
Thank you, number 3, Phoenix Singleton, for that. That's gonna put a first down for Knox. It was gonna be over if he ran that back. Bit of a tear in the defense there. They need to patch that up real quick. If they get another run like that in, it's going to be close to being over. Like that, they almost did. Nice tackle by number 40, Casey Ault. Oh, brother. We're 2-9 now. Come on, Comets. Your defense is rocking and socking, but so far it's slacking. Let's go. Looks to be another handoff. Someone push him out, please. Nice, taking him down. Number 53, Trent Howard, and I think there was a little bit of an assist there, but number 20, Brady. This is still first down for the Redskins, so either way, it's just... not good. We got about getting close to 8 minutes left on the count. And another handoff. What is he doing? Take him down. Alright. Put him down at about... what are they going to call that? They're going to call that 46 maybe? Yeah. 46 yard line. And it's just, it's not looking good. They're slowly able to gain, and I don't like it. See, there's another run, but maybe a loss. There we go. Number 54, Wesley York, just picking him up and throwing him back. That's what I like to see. should be a loss of yards. Or maybe not, you know, I call it like I see it, but sometimes I'm completely wrong in that effort. Maybe there was no gain. You know what? I'm content with that. I'd like to see something. He's going for a pass. Over. Interception. Yes, come on. That was a nice interception. My number 12, Zach Conrad. He's having trouble catching passes early on in this game, but that's good enough to make up for it. Nice interception there by Zach. All right, okay, turn this around. Get the momentum shifting. Let's get a touchdown. And hopefully in about 23 seconds, I'll get my co-commentating partner back here in a minute. Alright. Handoff to number 21, Efren. Come on, Efren. There you go. That's a gain. Okay, we're working. We're working. We're making movement. Movement's good. Ooh, we got a countdown on the clock. 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back.
Nice to see you again, Maddox.
Thank you. How's it come whenever you stop talking, something bad happens, but whenever I stop talking, something good happens?
I like to think I am a likable person. That might be kind of selfish of me to say, but I like to think that.
Well, you are.
But in most case scenarios, bad things happen whenever I'm around. But that was a nice run. Go, Casey!
Steps out.
That's what I like to see. That's what I like to see.
Maybe I should not talk more often.
No, it's good. It's good. We need your voice here. Come on. You're an opinion that needs to be commentated.
It's first and goal.
It's first and goal. 6 minutes to go. We can make this.
10-yard line.
We can make. Let's go. Come on. That was a nice run by Casey. Haven't seen a run that far in a while.
Casey's hurt.
Where?
Kind of limping off.
He is limping off. I better not be anything too bad.
Now we're going to need him for sectionals.
Oh, yeah. You're telling me if we don't got him, we're going to earn trouble.
Well, if we do have him, we're in trouble.
What do you mean? Three Phoenix trying to gain, but he lost one. It's okay. It's okay. Second and 11. We need a really good run or a pass, but I'm not that confident in our passes, so a really good run would be nice.
It's true.
Come on.
No whammies.
big bucks, no whammies on the run. Efren, number 21, let's go, come on.
Cut back right into the middle of them.
Get out progress. Of there.
And a late flag once again.
These officials are like really sketchy with the flag throwing here tonight.
No, they're really sensitive to it. I don't know what it is about them, but they're really sensitive to any and every type of foul that there is. If it's in the rule book, they're throwing it.
We must study a lot. Nerds.
Nerds. It's a rule book.
Yeah.
Kind of have to know the rules to be a ref.
Not necessarily to be a commentator. You can learn that on the job.
I don't know what he's doing.
I'm a good example of that one.
Okay, let's see what White Hat has to say. Personal foul against Knox once again.
Yes. Let's go. Come on, comments. If you guys don't score, Okay, I said that. I'm not going to say anything. Last time I said that, we fumbled it.
Okay.
All right. I'm gonna let this go. I'm not gonna say anything bad or anything good that could happen. Say he's looking for a pass. Oh, he's gonna go for it.
Gonna get a gain of one.
Come on, Brady. Come on, Brady. If you're not gonna pass, at least make sure you're open for a good run. Come on. Come on, lads. We got 5 minutes.
5 minutes and 5 yards.
Fourth down.
I don't think it's fourth down. I think it's second.
It's fourth down.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Maybe it is four.
Yeah. It is four.
All right. Come on.
He's in.
That's got to be in. Come on.
He's in.
Yes.
Touchdown.
Yes. That's a touchdown.
Yeah.
I haven't even...
really that happy?
I haven't been able to say that for so long.
Yeah, we only need 31 more.
I'm content. Okay. I can go home now. Yes.
All right.
Oh, I feel great. Lit. All right.
You should probably watch football a little more often so you know what's going on.
I do watch football. I watch it quite often at my dad's.
Who's your favorite team in NFL?
NFL? Seahawks.
Seahawks?
Yeah. I kind of bandwagoned them, to be honest, but then I kind of started to like them, so I kind of kept them.
What, do you like their colors or what?
No, it was... Well, why did I bandwagon them?
Because they were going to the Super Bowl.
That might have been why, and I just kind of stuck with them.
True. You know any players on there?
Nope.
Nope.
At least I watch it. I mean, gee. You can't tax me for memorizing stuff.
At least you're not a Patriots fan.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. You gotta be a special breed to be one of their fans.
That's Phoenix.
Okay. Well, we score. I mean, I don't know how it could get any better than that.
We could win.
Okay, now let's try something believable in the next 4 minutes and 30 seconds.
All right, that was a little rude.
If we can score again, that's believable.
That's true. Wait, was there a thing that we missed that was supposed to happen but didn't happen? Did we try for...
I don't think they tried for anything.
They tried for two and they missed.
Did they?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Man. There's no way we kicked. There's no way. We don't kick. We never kick.
We're just not too used to being in a press box or something. We're missing a lot of stuff.
This is the first time I've ever been in a press box, actually.
Oh, yeah. Because you're usually on camera outside. Yeah. All right, now the Comets are kicking the ball back off to Knox.
The second time they kicked the ball in the game.
Yeah. Feeling great.
Well, except for the safety.
Yeah, but... All right, here we go. 20. We got Brady on the kick.
Picks it up and throws it.
That'd be hilarious. That'll put him. Where did that put him? 45?
Yep.
Recovered by Campbell Howard.
Do you watch college? College football?
Occasionally.
Who's your favorite team? If you say Notre Dame, I'll kill you.
I'm not going to talk.
Okay.
Will you be more better if I say
I'm... More better?
Yeah, grammar. Yeah. Tax me for it. Would you be more content if I said maybe Purdue then?
Purdue's football is not... It's subpar.
Okay, so who's your team? Who's your team for college?
At least you're not bandwagon.
I'm not. I try not to be.
Well, IU almost beat Ohio State last year.
They did. I remember hearing about that.
They didn't beat them, but they
almost did.
Almost did. My mom's a big IU fan, so we watch every IU game.
I can imagine. IU's pretty good.
Yeah, she likes the Colts and she likes IU. She just likes Indiana.
That is true. All right, timeout's called in the field. We're going to take a really short break here. We'll be right back with you.
All right, welcome back to RTC TV. We got about 4 minutes left here in the fourth. We're in the fourth quarter, right?
Yes.
I lost track of time there for a second. Yeah, about 4 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Comets with actually on the scoreboard 6-37.
So since you're doing basketball this year, do you watch basketball?
You know, I kept up with it, like for the
the NBA championship.
Yeah, I kept up with it with that. But as far as like actually like consistently watching it, no, I have not.
No, like how Cavs beat Golden State when they were down in the series and they still came back and beat them. That was hilarious. I laughed. So hard.
That was great. But I'm definitely going to, I mean, basketball is one of my more favorite sports, so definitely I'm going to keep on it this year of all. Especially because playing a lot in the pep band, you know, being at our school games, you know, they're not as big as professional, but it still gets you hyped up and stuff like that, and I enjoy it a lot. That's the only sad part that I will be grieving over while commentating for the games is that I'll be missing out on the pep band.
We can do a pep commentary.
I could do a pep commentary. We could do that. I might just want to do that.
You could do that. If you're up for it.
I am up for anything. Well, James Keel, number 86, trying to jump and just snag that ball out of the midair. Don't know how you would do that. I guess it's possible.
Oh, was that Knox punting?
Yeah, that was Knox.
Oh. That was us punting.
Why would James jump and try and grab one of our own balls?
I saw James in the backfield, and I just thought that he was going to pull like what he did last game and just fumble it again.
Have a little faith in our players, Maddox.
Oh, I try to. I try to a lot. Don't get me wrong. I love them all.
Yeah, I know.
Sometimes, man. Sometimes.
Yeah, I know. I should be the least, you know, last person to say that considering I flip out, you know, a lot of the time. But, you know.
You flip out a lot.
I love them all. They're all great guys.
Most of them.
It's been a real fun ride filming for them.
You've been commentating for them.
It's been a real fun ride commentating for them.
There you go.
I've enjoyed every second of it.
We're going to stop at pie. There's going to be timeout called by Comets.
All right, timeout's called. We'll be right back with you after the break. You know, I finally got why you said that we were stopping on pie because the time had 3:14 on it.
I thought someone got that.
Pie 3.14.
Tangled up in the backfield, we have yet another Conrad coming out on the field. Caleb Conrad, the youngest of the three that play on the football team.
The youngest of the three Conrads, yeah. Sport number 10, I keep forgetting that's what that's his number.
Yep, he's on JV team.
Exercising some of the JV players, I guess.
I mean, what can you do?
Not a lot. Especially with 2 minutes and 40 to go.
Walker, Walker, Walker.
Comets 2-10. Ooh, a hand fumble.
At least he found the ball.
Number 5. That's another JV player, isn't it? I feel like I know him. Do you? I do.
Because you don't know who number 4 is, so I can't imagine you know who number 5 is.
I do know who number 4 is. That's Alex.
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 Exactly. You don't even know his last name.
I'm sorry. I've only just started talking to him and making friends with him recently.
He's a foreign exchange student.
I know
Spain.
He is.
Yeah.
He's a real great guy.
He is a real good guy. Every foreign exchange student is just really nice.
Mm-hmm.
Well, can't speak for everyone else, so every experience I've had with a foreign exchange student, they're all really nice.
Oh, yeah. But who's number 5 for us?
I don't know. Why don't you ask?
I can't really ask. No one else here knows.
Yeah, it's true. I don't know either.
I'm just going to assume he's a great guy.
Well, everyone on our team is a great guy.
Yeah.
Except for a select few.
A select few?
A select few people that are just not
nice people.
On the team. Every team has that bad apple.
True.
Or apples.
Or apples. Yeah, true.
Yeah.
All right, well, we're rearing about a minute left in the fourth quarter.
So, what do you think? I mean, you said we'd score.
And I'm pretty close to what...
You're pretty close.
Knox was at. I almost had that.
Not too far from the truth, my friend.
I think I was only 1 point off on Knox.
Would you say 38?
I think so.
I'm not really sure what you said. I can't remember.
At 38 or 36, I think I'm only 1 point off.
Why don't you be like completely watch? You said like 60 something.
We'll only find out, you know, when we get this footage sent to editing.
We'll find out next time on Redskin Football. Or actually, it's RTC Video.
RTC Video. What school do you think we're sporting?
Because this is home. This is home.
This is home for them, yeah.
Yeah, so I would just think.
Yeah. Nah, it's fine. It's fine. I see where your loyalty is
like. It's nothing to, like, you know. I'm just, who's the home team here?
Okay. I see where you're coming from with this.
You're trying to make me sound like a bad guy, and I'm not.
I know you're not.
That's fine.
No, you're not.
I get it. My mom tells me I'm a bad guy every day.
Yo, come on now.
Looks like that would be game.
It looks like
final
gonna
score
be
is going to be 37 Knox, 6 Caston.
All right. Well, I'd like to thank you all for tuning in and watching RTC TV 4 tonight. This might be our last football game for the season.
It's been a privilege, though.
It's been a fun ride so far. Feel free to check out our website, rtc4.com, and our YouTube channel.
Or watch the previous games.
Or watch the previous games. Well, I'm Dakota Hayden, and this is Matt Exider, and thank you all for watching.